When I woke up this morning to prepare for my morning masses, for those of you who don't know, I'm a Catholic and I attend morning masses. So as I got up this morning, 5:45, to prepare for morning mass, as I was in the bathroom bathing, I was punching my body peacefully and singing to my Lord. And the Spirit ministered to me and said, "My daughter Calista, go into the world and prophesy to my daughters who are looking for a life partner. Give them the secret, and if they follow it, I promise them they will find the right partner. As in, they will catch the right guy." So I'm here to do the Lord's work. It's not my talking, no. It's not my, I'm not the one talking. And let me tell you, if you don't watch to the end, you are going to lose. If you don't watch to the end, you are going to miss out, because I'm going to prophesy. I'm going to prophesy and release blessing into your life, so that those of you who are eagerly looking for a life partner, especially my sisters out there, you'll find the right man and all will be well. So if this kind of content that you like from me, or you want me to always give out, please make sure you leave a comment in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed, because I really appreciate it for you to subscribe. And for those that just joined my family, please, please go and watch that my video. Get to know me. You will get to know all. You will know, because it's that video specifically explains me as a person. That is just it. So go and watch that video and watch the rest of the video. And please share my video. So let's go back to today's discussion, or to the ministration. See, in 2018, I'm going to share this story then before I dive into it. So in 2018, I met my husband, then my boyfriend. He was in love with someone else. Yes, he was in love with someone else. Actually, they just broke up. Me, I broke up from a relationship. Himself broke up from the relationship. He was in a relationship that did not work. Me, I was in a stupid relationship. But let me use that language. It was a stupid and a stupid relationship that I was. And both of us separated in 2017. And everybody, I didn't know him then. He doesn't know me. We know ourselves. So I think something happened 2020. I was supposed to go for a surgery. And mind you, I'm based in Ondo State. As at then, I was by myself. I just came into Ondo State, Ondo Town, October 2017. And I was booked for a surgery. Something happened and I was booked for a surgery in March. March, April, thereabout. So I needed people to donate blood from me, since I was by myself. And I went to the blood bank. I was asked to bring people to donate blood for me. And I started looking for people. I searched, imagine I'm barely like 6 months in the town without having any family member. I searched and I searched and I searched, and along the line, one of my colleague, former colleague, introduced me to him, and he willingly gave his blood for me, and that was how we became friends. And he was there by my side, I think 24/7. He was there by my bedside all through my surgery, everything was there. And after the whole surgery, I went home and I came back. And we became friends. Just normal friends. No strings attached. We were friends. And something happened. One thing led to another. He was like, he wants to date me. He wants us to start dating. I was like, I'm looking for a husband. I'm not looking for a boyfriend. Yes, this is what I told him. I was like, I'm looking for a husband. I'm not looking for a boyfriend. And moreover, if I date you, I'm going to hurt you, because that is my decision as I did. So he was still persistent, and I was like, okay. And I told him what happened, everything he needed to know, why I didn't want to go into a relationship. And he was like, okay, no. And I was like, then we became friends. And long story short, whenever we are around, we started dating naturally. Long story short, started dating. Whenever we are around, you always tell me that he's in love with someone else, that if the person comes back, we'll go back to the person. He will do this one, he will do that one, he will do this one. Me, I was like, in my head, then why did you come to me? You see why, if I do bad now, they will say I'm wicked. I did not tell him, I was already saying this in my heart. Then one day, the Lord now ministered to his daughter, which is me, yes. And said, my daughter, I gave you a talent free of charge, because I know that the men that will come around you will desire that talent. I gave you a talent. Use it on this person. Use it on this person, my daughter. Use it. And all this your complaint will end. Hi, my sisters and the Lord. That is where the story now changed. You. I didn't tell him anything. No, I was just doing the ministry that God said I should do. I love cooking. Let me tell you, I love cooking. Not just I love cooking. I cook very well. I can even stand to say I'm a chef, even if I've not gotten to that level. But I can beat my chest and say yes, I'm a full-time chef. Yes, I love cooking. I love experimenting new recipes and trying out so many things. My dear sisters and the Lord, that is how I caught this man. Every day, anytime he's not in my house, I will cook one new recipe that I know he has never tasted. I'll cook it, I will snap it and send to my parents at home, to my family in Asaba. I'll send one to him online or on WhatsApp and I'll eat my food. He will just be like, why are you not sending me this food? Why are you not sending me pictures? This is a few to call me to eat. Pim, I will not send it to him. Next time again, I will cook another one. I will send to him on WhatsApp. Not free one, not real food. That was just what I was doing, doing. So we started dating around December. We started dating May 2018. I think we started dating May 29th, 2018. That was official when we started dating. So, but I didn't start doing all this my ministration till like, let's say, towards the ending of January, towards the ending of the year. That was when I said, okay, and I realized that myself, I like this guy. Okay, let me just pray. And now then the Lord now ministered. I should use my talent and win his heart. And that was what I did. I used food. Food. Yes, my brothers and sisters and the Lord. For my sisters, all the guys, close your ears because this video is not for you. Or you can share to somebody, your sister, if you have a sister. Or you have a female friend, can share this video to them so they will know what to do. So me, in my own case, I used food. See, that thing they say that the way to a man's heart is through his stomach. See, my sisters and the Lord is not lying. I am a living testimony of that. I started cooking, and God now buttered my bread. You know how God buttered the bread and sugared the tea and add honey and everything to my own. I did all this cooking for like the whole of January. No, the whole of 2019. I was doing it once in a while, mostly on weekend because once I'm at home on weekends, Saturdays and Sundays. Goodness me, I feed my body well. So Saturdays and Sundays, I always cook a whole lot of dishes. I was living alone, but I cook. So that was what I was doing. Basically, I would cook, and sometimes I would invite him. So let me tell you some of the dishes I made. I made like assurance yam, I made geese dodo, I made, what are they calling it here? Conviv dodo, I made minced dodo, I made anything food. I'm just saying, these are some of the recipes I made. Then 2019, this guy was not 2020, it was 2019, and then he was now beginning to talk of marriage. He would be like, that don't worry, I'm going to marry you. Once in a while, we just chip it in. Are you going to marry me? Will you marry me? This was just what he was always saying. It was not really direct. He was always like, will you marry me? I'll be like, of course, I don't have issue about that. If you are ready, I'm ready. So, fast forward to 2020, March, when COVID. See, I was the people that COVID blessed and took away from. Yes, let me tell you what happened. Why I say I am among those that COVID favored and still took something away from me. Yes, COVID took away my daddy and gave me a husband. So that is my story. If you want to know that story, leave a comment in the comment section and I'll tell you that story. So back to my discussion. So that COVID period, he was in Akure, me I'm in Ondo. So he went for a posting in Akure, me I was in Ondo. So he, there where he was in Ondo, they entered into that shutdown before me. Since me, I was working in a school, we were still on section. So he now came down to Ondo. And he was living in a separate house, and I stayed by myself. So because of the COVID, me, I needed a companion. I did not go. I was thinking the shutdown would be something like 1 week or 2 weeks. They will resume back. So I did not travel. Fortunately for me, that was a blessing in disguise. Because in a very normal day, every month I travel home. But imagine when they shut down the whole state and I did not go. I was like, okay, let me just stay back. Instead of going, maybe when they will ask us to resume from work, I will not be able to come back to my base. So I had to stay back. I do know that shutting down would take like another 3, 5, 4 months. But that was how my story changed. So during that COVID, that was when we had opportunity to experiment. Like, you know, I was at home, like, COVID, you know what happened, everybody was in indoors, nothing to do. But me now, in my indoors, I was not experimenting in my kitchen. Whenever I would have opportunity, because even the market, remember the market, everything was shut down. So whenever I have the opportunity to go to the market, I go. When I go, I buy a whole lot of things that we need to keep in the house. So I was experimenting. During the COVID, that was when I learned how to bake bread. I never knew how to make bread. I baked bread. I made chin-chin. I made granite. And my cooking now took another turn because I was at home jobless, no work to do. So the work I was doing was cooking. We are cooking, we are eating. Practically, for most of the time, we always spend most of the time but in my own side because I was cooking. I was always cooking. And most times I would invite my uncle around. We would spend the time together. He would go back to his place. It was just like that. But let me tell you, the bottom line of this story is that I used what God gave to me to catch a husband. So let me tell you out there, as my ladies, if you are into a very serious relationship, I mean serious relationship, and the guy is not saying anything like marriage, let me tell you, discover what God gives. See, each and every one of us out there, God gave us a specific gift that our husband we need, we love about us. And for my own, he gave me cooking. I can be in the kitchen from morning to night. I can decide to wake up and say, even at 8 p.m. that I want to eat something, and it's available in my house, I will make it. I don't even care. Even if I finish making it 10 p.m., I will eat it that 10 p.m. It's not my problem. So let me tell you, the secret or the bottom line of this video is that discover that gift that God has given to you. God did not give you that gift because he wants you to put it inside your bag. No. If you are looking for a life partner, if you are somebody that loves cooking and you have passion for cooking, it means that God gave you that gift to be able to catch whatever you want to catch. If you have you're in a relationship, let me tell you, use food. Use food and cleanliness to catch that man. Make his head turn so that he will remember that, oh, if I leave this girl, somebody else will enjoy all this thing. So that is what happened to me. I know that he will not say it, but when we talk about it now, it's so funny actually. When we talk about it, he will just start laughing. Like, look at you. I use food to confuse your brain. In your mind, you are like, maybe you are not thinking of marriage. You knew that if you lose me, you are going to lose a whole lot. Because now, you know that it's difficult to see more ladies out there who can invest so much time in cooking. People who will not invest so much time like few of us. I know there are few of us out there who love cooking, who invest our time in cooking. So husband, man has to come and marry me. In fact, that COVID period, May 20, that March, his birthday, it was just the two of us now, his birthday was May. For his birthday, I now baked cake for him. I baked 2 cakes. I made rice and stew with salad. I celebrated the birthday for him and even had some to share with his friends. And you know what? After that birthday, husband man proposed to me officially. And in May, we went to see my parents. And along the line, last July, okay, after I went to see my parents, my father died in June. In July, my bride price was paid. In December, I got married. I did my white wedding officially. So let me tell you that my secret of cooking, my gift of cooking, helped me to catch a man. And that is why the Spirit has said, I shall come and tell you this secret. See, look for that special gift that God gave me, that you know that when you do, people will be like, wow, you did try, share. Look for that inside of you and use it on any man that will catch you. See, if this my gift of cooking did not only work for my husband. I remember when I came here to... The first time I came to Ondo here to process my job interview and the rest of them, somebody helped me. And I remember when I, the first day I entered the house and I made food, I cleaned up the house. Everyone was looking sparkling, clean and food. It was a man, he's like a father to me. Well, like, listen, wow. Are you a typical example of what a wife should be? And my presence in the house really changed the whole thing. Because he was practically buying food. I came that day, I cooked. In fact, I traveled like 6 hours from him. I cooked, I got to the house, and I cleaned the house, and I made food for him. I took care of him like I would take care of my own family. And he made that comment that, wow, that God, if he was not married, then he would have gotten married to me. So that we tell you that each of us out there, my sisters out there, God has placed in you a specific gift, specific talent that you can use very well to harness anything you want. Me, I know that I love cooking. My talent is cooking and chores, like cleaning the house. I can keep everything happening clean. So I know that whenever I find myself in any way to catch people's attention in that house, I'm going to cook. I'm going to clean, because it's not like pretending. That is who I am. I can cook very well and I can clean. In fact, you can just allow me to be cooking. Don't give me any other work and I will gladly do that without complaining. Sorry if I'm touching my hair. My hair is too long, it's disturbing me. So that is my gift. So I use it. So you as a person, look for that special gift that God has given to you and use it to make your man. Never think of any other person. Let me tell you something. Yesterday, today is Saturday. Yesterday, I was washing. When I was washing with my husband, we washed clothes together. And that, there's something I now said. You now said, come. I should come and tell you. Is it that I used food to catch? I was like, I played my game well. I did not do anything and you fell for it and now you are enjoying it. That your heart, that you thought that you are sensible, happy. I think you have sense. But we just talk, like, we'll talk about it and laugh about it. But the truth is that it worked. It worked for me. Choma Davido, Davido's girlfriend or wife now. It's not what food she used in confusing Davido's head. Let's talk through. She used food to make Davido to fall in love with her and to scatter his brain and decides to marry her. So let me tell you, this one, there are so many persons that have used cooking and the gifts that God gave to them to get a man for themselves. I'm not saying you should throw yourself at the man, no. If you're in a relationship and you know this person is okay and he's supposed to be married and he's busy doing, his brain is touching, reset it by your cooking. Reset it using that gift that God has placed in you free of charge to do whatever you like, and I promise you that that man surely put the ring on that finger, because it worked for me and it worked for so many people. So I've done the Lord's work, and Lord, let me pray for you. People, close your eyes. Father Lord, bless our sisters out there that are looking for the life, that are looking for a life partner. Bless them with the right choice and give them the insight on what to do to be able to get the right man and how to get the godly man. This we ask to Christ our Lord. Amen. Peace be with you. And always remember that Jesus loves you. Adieu.